Jesus and the Great Trunks. Angel fights on Highlander MMA by way of Tampa, Florida. Blades of the Aces, American top team, open a great fast-paced action so far. As we see the Aces shoving Angel aside there. Both men with fast footwork in the early seconds. How many times was slowdowns on call of action?
Blades have been training the ATT for a very long time. He's the next generation style.
I tell you what, I remember seeing him coming in clean in the mats, you know, so like, I thought it was good to actually watch him and call his first pro fight.
Alex Dye with you ringside alongside UFC veteran Dean Thomas and current UFC fighter Rich Lurigico at Toledo. Rich also an alumnus of the Ultimate Fighter Season 11. As we see the takedown work on it completed by Blazer De Jesus in the side control of Sebastian Angel. Fight Time 6 is brought to you by Patriot National Insurance Group. Strength, excellence, and tenacity in the workers' comp arena. Rich, you've worked a lot with Blades of the Aces. You've seen his athleticism firsthand. What are some of the things in this case capable of?
I mean, he's well-rounded in every area. He's been training for a really long time since he was a young kid. I come from a capoeira background. I've seen him do about 25 backflips in a row. Just unbelievable, phenomenal athlete. He's capable of ending the fight in any position, but he's going to be very careful not to get overzealous here.
A lot of scrambles on the ground. The Aces was in the full mount momentarily, but bumped off very quickly by Angel. You saw that up kick just missed. Both men back to their feet. Superman punch just short. The Aces scored with a couple of punches in a knee.
Yeah, very well-rounded Muay Thai skills.
I can hear that leg kick from here. That hurt my body.
Very dynamic athlete.
He is fast.
Shades of maybe Demetrius Mike House Johnson. That kind of speed being displayed by Blades of the Aces.
He's young. He's only 18 years old. You know, I've seen him in the gym, and he sticks with it, and he's mind focused. Then the sky's the limit for this kid.
Sebastian Angel, 1-0 in his young MMA career. Blades of the Aces making his pro debut. Both guys who will loss if somebody's bow has to go here in the Fight Time game. Big knees. Responding is Angel with a combination. Now he's working for the takedown.
Angel's great game.
Yeah, Angel came to fight. He didn't push over. He didn't come out here and just go,
This has been what you'd expect so far from a bantamweight fight. 139 pounds. These guys are moving in fast motion. Armbar attempt and then the slam by De Jesus. And now he's going for a leg lock.
He's going for a leg lock now. He's out of the calf. He's not in a really good position for him.
Every time you go for a leg lock, you got to be careful not to give up on your own legs.
Still breaking now. Is it deeper now, guys?
It's hard to call it. He's just now moving a little too fast for me to register what's going on.
Yeah, and Angel is, man, he's tough, man. He's scrappy. He didn't stop moving, and he was able to transition out of that submission attempt.
I have felt for a long time, guys, that 135 pounders are my favorite weight class in MMA, and it's fights like this that illustrate why. Still working on that leg. Breaking his Blades of the Aces.
He's going to get that foot up into his armpit and stroke that heel hook successfully.
Now on top, working for side control. He's Angel, dropping down the elbows, ground and pound, dropping the heavy lumber, working for a finish, tied up now by De Jesus. Neither of these guys show signs of tiring so far. Another reversal, and it has been scrambles galore here, guys.
Yeah, this is some way to make a debut, that's for sure. And you're going to see what De Jesus is all about coming in round two here.
Another slam, second one of the round. De Jesus on top, and we will go to round two. Round number two of this bantamweight fight, Sebastian Angel in the black trunks, plates into Jesus in the gray trunks. That first round was fast-paced. Overhand right landed. And another one, both men exchanging punches. De Jesus with the takedown, another scramble. This has been an awesome fight thus far. Alex Donna with you here ringside, alongside UFC veteran Dean Thomas, current UFC fighter Rich Hatsumito, alumnus of the Ultimate Fighter, season 11. American Top Team's Coconut Creek plays into Jesus in top control with the cage in the full guard. Sebastian Angel for 10 from Florida on the bottom.
There's been a non-stop action kind of fighter. These guys have transitioned into every position possible. Like in that first 5 minutes, you see everything happening. A lot of armbar looks deep.
Oh, he is cranking that armbar. Sebastian Angel didn't make the drive down to the top and throw it in the rooms to the local kid. Cranking on that arm. A lot of composure, though, being shown by Grayson to Jesus. No panic yet. That looks painful.
Let's see from this angle how deep it is. Try to slow this fight down and get control of it because it's been all over the place all the time.
Well, I think it goes back to what you were saying about breaking the round. Is that when you are good at everything, you have a tendency to want to do everything. And I love these guys who just go very well rounded, so they're using all the tools instead of just like, okay, you know what? I'm going to see if I can do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do
it. We talked about the well-rounded nature of Blake's innovation. He's only the fighter who most successful in the UFC is George St. Pierre. Kind of has similar skill set where he really is skilled in every area of mixed martial arts. It's that new generation, Rich, that you talk about that MMA fighters are bringing to the cage.
And here he is with his armbar attack.
Oh, and the tap! Submission victory after a hard-fought foot battle.
Try to slow this fight down and get control of it because it's been all over the place all the time.
Well, I think it goes back to what you were saying about breaking the round. Is that when you are good at everything, you have a tendency to want to do everything. And I love these guys who just go very well rounded, so they're using all the tools instead of just like, okay, you know what? I'm going to see if I can do it. I'm going to do a week there and try to dominate
that. We talked about the well-rounded nature of Blake's innovation. He's only the fighter who most successful in the UFC is George St. Pierre. Kind of has similar skill set where he really is